Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to some more Elder Scrolls Arena. In the last video I told you that I would take some time off screen to basically, you know, grind enough money so that I can purchase, you know, like 100 potions of healing. And, well, there's an update on that. The thing is, I basically found a ebony helm on my second raid. Just look at this, I mean, it really gives me a -5 boost to, like, the head AR. However, I mean, just the head doesn't exactly seem like such a big deal, and I can really appreciate the boost to speed which this helmet gives me, so I'm just gonna stick with this for the time being. And I basically found a few other things, such as a few marks. I got them identified as well. And I've got a few braces, a bracelet, a belt, and whatever this is, I mean, whatever this belt is, I don't know what belt this is, and I can't exactly identify it since it cost me a lot of money. However, what this belt did was it gives me this immense boost. It's like a -4 boost to all of my AR, and that's amazing. So I'm gonna keep this. What I'm going to do now is I'm gonna just go ahead and sell my ebony helm so that I can get like 30,000 gold, and actually more than 30,000. I'm pretty sure I can haggle my way up to 40,000 or somewhere around that line, so that I can basically get enough money to, you know, purchase health potions and stuff, because we are going to need that in Fang Lair. Unlike this dungeon, like Stonekeep, Fang Lair actually has the objective at the very end of the map, so we are actually going to need to scour the entire map to actually get there. And I'm going to purchase a few potions of resist fire and a few potions of invisibility as well, because as far as I've read, we will be needing them. And another news, it's raining in Hammerfall, so that's good. So I think I'm gonna catch up with you guys once I'm actually in Fang Lair and I've done the rest of this stuff. So see you guys later then. I mean, it will be a cut for you anyway, so. Fang Lair. You stand before the Dragon Gate of Fang Lair, humbled before its majesty. The Dwarven Hold seems abandoned long ago, stone walls cracking with age and neglect. Somewhere within its tank depths lies the first piece of the stack of the Staff of Chaos. Alright guys, so we are finally at Fang Lair, and I have to tell you, this is my first time raiding this place. So I really don't know what's gonna happen to me or how it's gonna turn out. I did a few things off screen. I basically sold the ebony helm and got a few things from all the money. Just look at how ugly this guy looks now. I mean, the dwarven boots look nice, but the steel pauldron, okay. The elven gauntlets, no. But the thing is, it is all functional. Like, really functional. So here's what it's about. I got the Dwarven Boots of Personality, which lets me haggle better, so plus and a boost to AR, I'll take it. Cuirass of Personality as well, because I couldn't exactly find a cuirass with better enchantments. Once I do, I will be donning that instead of this. Steel Pauldron of Levitation, this one. Now, in case I need some levitation, but I don't know whether I would. The Pauldron of Agility, which is this one, which gives me a massive agility boost. Elven Gauntlets of Speed, these ugly looking things actually increase my speed, so yeah, I'm gonna keep them. Steel Helm of Speed as well, and I actually did this during one of my raids. I also got the Saber of Agility. Now, this also increased my agility by 10 points, so it all seems like a good deal. Yeah, that's it. I bought like 15 potions of resist fire. Actually, I couldn't buy 100 potions of heal true, but I bought like 109 potions of heal true. The thing about the potions of healing is that they're half the price, but they're a gamble. They don't always heal you to your max health every single time. So I just feel like putting in double the price for something that'll give you the assurance of getting healed to the max all the time, it just seems like a better deal to me. So yeah, anyway, I got the push 99 potions of heal true. I already had 10 from before, and 3 potions of invisibility for a fight, a potential fight with Cerberus that comes up next. I mean, he's supposed to disappear, but I've read that sometimes it doesn't, so might as well be ready, you know. Anyway, so with that being said, let's go ahead and get this. You stand in Fang Lair, its dwarven hewn passages run for miles under the earth. I'm sure they do. See, the sad part about Fang Lair is that we'll have to... Oh, look at this. Look at this. Blade boots, longsword. I mean, if they don't really give me much, I'm just gonna drop them because I could really use the sword space. So, blade boots, yeah. Drop. And... the longsword is enchanted. I like it. I'll keep that. So, see, that's the thing about loot. You want to, you know, get some loot that's enchanted, just so that, you know, you can sell it for higher price if you don't like it. You can make much more money off it than you can if you just use something which, you know, isn't enchanted. So, yeah. So I'm just gonna mark this as the entry ladder. That's a A, that's a K, yeah, entry ladder. So I'll just mark this here, and that apparently is a raised platform somewhere. Not this, of course, but is it? Looks more like a pit to me, but anyway. So the thing about Fangler is we're gonna have to raid all of it, like literally raid all of it. We're really going to have to get to the end of the map, find a way to the end of the map to get our objective. So it's gonna be a lot of resting here and there, wherever we go, basically. So that's the only thing about Fang Lair. I wish I could break these barrels. Can I break these barrels? Let's try. Nope. Can't interact with them. They're just decorative pieces there. So I think this is the way then. There was something over here as well. Let's just go ahead and check it out. If we can do that. Oh, we can. And there appears to be nothing here. So that is the only way. Let's go then. The mining gate, and not exactly a gate, I mean it is much more of a, the tunnel seems to stretch on endlessly, but the tracks you have come across usually lead to entire shafts. So okay, so let's just make sure we, so see, there are two paths here we can go by. Yes, there are two paths we can go by, but in the long run, there's always time to change the rope you're on. Sorry, I couldn't resist. Oh yeah, look at this, a skeleton. Right off the bat, I have to face a skeleton. At least it was just one skeleton, not like two skeletons have nothing usable. So... yeah, we're just gonna have to figure out which one, where we have to go. So this is the mining gate, we know that. This was something which I can't even figure out what this is. I'm pretty sure we could levitate over into the center, but, or we could even jump over into the center, but I don't exactly want to risk it. So anyway, moving on. We can try going here, we can try going there, we can try going here or here. Where should we go first? Let's start with this one. Ah, more skeletons. My old friends. I've come to destroy you. I'm really struggling with the downstroke here. Yeah, finally. Got it. And now I'll probably be struggling with the upstroke. They weren't as difficult as the ones I faced in Fang Lair. Nah, really wouldn't like the buckler, to be honest. Nope. 3 gold first half, hell no. I ain't buying that. So, this is not the way. So, the thing they said at the beginning, I think that might be a hint for us to know where to go. Because these tunnels, they always, you know, they said that these tunnels lead up to a surface or something, so might as well just follow those tunnels there. And I'm getting barely damaged, I wonder why. Is it because of the AR boost that I got? I don't know, I can't really tell, because I was getting really damaged back then. Skeleton has nothing usable, the skeleton has nothing usable. They're all useless skeletons. Or are these skeletons just, you know, set to a easier difficulty than the rest? Well, there seems to be another way here. I'll just mark this place as exit up, just so that I don't forget. Rail tracks. I wonder where these go. Through the tunnels. With more places to explore. Huh, this might be the right way to go. I don't really know, so... Is that loot? Yes, it is. It is loot. Loot, sweet loot. And a Wakizashi, so let me just check whether that Wakizashi is enchanted or not. No, it is not. Kindly drop. This might be where I have to go, I don't really know. So what I'll do is I'll just go back here and check first. And then make a decision based on that. So we came from here, I suppose. Man, I suck at navigating. Yeah, we did. So we'll go up here and just follow these tracks. There was nothing over there. There might be something here. Let's check. A ghoul. Nice to meet you, ghoul. It's time for you to die now. So these guys are apparently the standard here. Skeletons and ghouls. The bosses we fought from. Stone Keep. I'll just mark this place as exit right, even though I don't need it right now. I'll just for the sake of it. Just to get it into practice, you know. There is a pit there, and nothing here. I like it. A whole lot of nothing. Cool. So, yeah. That was the right way. I feel like my character has been moving quite faster the last few, you know, for some time now. I think that's because of the boost to speed which I got. It may be, it may not be, but I sure hope it is. So, yeah. So where do we go now? This is where I put my stuff. And there is nothing here. Why would they even make a railroad that winding? Like, seriously. And that place has sunken. I hear skeletons. I do not see them though. I'm just gonna mark this place as exit up. I like how the font varies from time to time, depending on, you know, whatever it is that you're doing, so... Is this... No, it isn't. Bag of 12 gold pieces? I think we have come a full circle here. I don't know. I'm not sure. It seems to be. Let's go try going right, just to confirm. Because we can go right here, so... We did come full circle here. So... We can keep going straight to get to that place, and that was that. Let's check it out. So, what did we find here? Yeah, so that... At least we got this entire part mapped up. So, might as well see. So, this is why I'm marking all these places here. Because the entry gate has now disappeared. And all these marks will keep disappearing as and when we keep progressing lower into the dungeon. So, it's a good thing to keep marking these places. Anyway, moving on. Let's try this path here. I have already marked it as exit up. Is there anything here? No, there isn't. So, that seems to be the only way to go. Don't fall there in there. It's gonna be bad news bears if you do. Let's just save it there, and... Yep. Something happened. Okay. Nothing here. So we should just mark the spaces exit up as well. For when we need to leave the space, you know. If we do leave this place. Yeah, that was something again. Sounds a bit scary, but I don't really know what that is. What is that sound? Extra space? Ah, shit. But that was not what I heard, to be honest. Let's see here. Exit up. Yeah, there are two paths here. I'm not gonna sing it again, don't worry. Okay. This appears to be something. Oh, skeleton. Skeleton-chan. Time to die. Die, please. Come on. Yeah, that's good. A buckler? Nah. What is with all these poor skeletons, man? Like... And this seems to be a dead end as well, so... Let's retrace our steps and see where we have to go, I guess. That was cool. Another buckler. No gold for me. I mean, I can pick up those bucklers and stuff, but then again, they don't really fetch a lot of gold. And I guess it might be coming from somebody who just sold an ebony helmet, but yeah, they don't really sell, like, have a lot of gold to sell. So I guess we came the wrong way. Let's backtrack. Unless there's something over here. Which there ain't. Curious. So... This way is a dead end, this way is a dead end. I guess we'll be going up this way? I suppose that is pretty much the only explanation left at this point. And I hear something snarling every time I go in there, but I can't seem to see whatever it is. Well, now we're stuck, aren't we? Curious. Because as we can see here, all these walls, their walls are all around, so these can't be the way. I wonder where the way is then. Not here, certainly. That's a dead end as well, because I mean there are walls here. And even if there aren't, we'll just, you know, end up out here somewhere. That is quite strange. Quite strange. I guess we'll just go back here and check? And no, man. Strange indeed. Because if there was a gate there, it would actually show up on the map as a red gate, but it isn't, so the only possible explanation is that there isn't a gate there. It's just walls all around, all over. Unless I have to fall into like one of these pits, which really shouldn't be the case. Unless there's something here? No, there's nothing here. We checked before. And there's nothing here either. These tracks just seem to run into nowhere. So, where are we supposed to go? I'm pretty certain it's not over here. Because there doesn't really seem to be a way here. Unless we actually have to jump into one of these gaps. Oh boy. Is that how it is? Let me just check real quick. Let me just save the game here. In the slot. And let us check. So where is the nearest gap? I think this one should take us somewhere. So let's see. My mineshaft B. Oh my god. So that is where we go. I cannot see anything here. And where did I pop up here? A completely parallelly running pathway. Well, that's something. I'll just... Nah, not here. I'll mark this here. Or here. I'll just mark this on the mineshaft. Mineshaft B. It's a mineshaft. I'll just place this as exit up. Another mineshaft there. An Orsimer, come here. Two hits, that's it. The Orsimer has nothing nothing usable. Well, boohoo. So there's nothing over there. And that is where mineshaft B would have come out. So, exit up here. Let's try going this way. Just to see where it goes, you know, where it all leads. Where does this mineshaft go? I really don't know. If all else fails, we'll just have to, you know, like check out the mineshafts, but until the time that I don't have to, I can travel on the ground, then I shall check the ground instead. Ooh, a Minotaur. Let me just quickly... Nah, that's fine. I can take a few hits. Yeah. Potion of resist fire, potion of heal true. See? Back to full health. Just like that. Nothing usable. Why do you even bother me then? This is going to be a long dungeon raid, I can feel it. So, exit up. You know, you just got to mark it. Well, I guess no one would ever be, you know, following me into the mineshafts. An orc! Die, orc. Nothing usable. Great. And this is a dead end. So, yay. Unless there's a mineshaft here. Which we will be coming back to later. No, there isn't. So, up we go. Let's go back here through the darkness. I think they are basically telling us where to go in a sense, with, you know, shimmering things on the floor and blood trails and stuff. I don't know, I mean, I will have to confirm that, because right now I'm just looking at the walls. Oh, two logs. Now this is gonna be fun. He just falls down into like a hunk of goop. Sad that I have to kill you all. Something happened. Yeah, I mean, this actually helps, so exit up. Good. Exit all the way up to mineshaft B. Wait, was that, like, some place to go? No, it wasn't. Cool. So, this place is cordoned off. Would it be the proper term to say, cordoned off? I don't really think so, but... what the hell? Nothing usable. A whole lot of nothing. I mean, we don't exactly need much at this point, but... you know, it always feels good to have something to use. So this seems to be a dead end as well, except we do have a mineshaft here. Might as well try, you know? Never know where it takes us. Way down we go. Oh, 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 oh. So, wait, what was the name of this mineshaft again? It ain't self-identifying, so... I didn't get a name there, I'll just name this the exit mineshaft, I guess. Now we can either go up there, or we can come up through the side here, or we can go further down the road and join up with this mineshaft. So I guess that sort of, you know, makes up. I'm guessing if I go forward here, I'll end up here, you know, at this entry point. So I guess I'll just take a right here and see where this takes us. This seems to be an exit here. We did exit somewhere, and that sounds like a skeleton. So is there a skeleton? Ah, yes, right there. There you are, boy. Time to die, boy. My god, this skeleton did a lot of damage. Was it two criticals in a row? I think it was. Huh. That should teach you a lesson. Buckler, no thank you. So... yeah, that was an exit mineshaft. Whew. Interesting. An expansive room. The blood goes this way. Outlast, follow the blood. But then again, the blood might also be going this way. You never really know. And I think this mineshaft takes us here. I think. But no, it doesn't. Does it? I don't really know. I'll have to check. Anyway, let's just go down this way, I guess? Let me just quickly mark this place here. So, where is this crawling guy though? Is the question. Belt. Let's just quickly check what this belt does. What this belt does? Oh, come on. Pronounce properly, son. So... oh, yeah. I need to unequip this first. and not a significant boost, to be honest. I'll just keep this instead, and I'll sell you off sometime later. Yeah, I knew it was an ox. I mean, it was sounded like an ox, so... Yeah, 3 hits, see? 40 gold pieces, that's nice. That's nice, I'll take that. I shall take that. I shall heartily accept. 44 gold pieces and a mark, which I can use for something. 49 gold pieces, look at that. I'm so lucky. I'm just gonna save in Warrior 2 here, and we shall explore a little bit, and then I suppose I shall call it quits. Because I mean, I do have a life, and I have got other things which I want to do, so... We can check this area out. Interesting. Dwarven ruins, but I mean, they did disappear. The dwarves did disappear when they used the Heart of Lorcan, or the Numidium for debate, really. But yeah, this seems to be like a whole other section to the map, and I don't really know where to go from here. Might be over here, might be down here. Can't really tell, no, can be. I mean, we can probably use this tunnel here. No, we can't. I'm pretty sure this tunnel connects there and, you know, comes out over here, so... Anyway. Where do we go? So that is the mineshaft. Are those skeletons? I mean, they sound a little different. They didn't exactly sound like skeletons, but yeah, I'll deal with them in a moment. This seems to be another entire section to the map, so... I'll just edit this in. Yeah, I'll just mark this as exit up. Not ip. Up. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, come along. Time for you to die then. You liked that, didn't you? You liked that, didn't you? Useless ghoul. The ghoul has nothing for me and has the nerve to attack me. Like, seriously. What do these guys think they are? Especially when I've been killing their comrades all along. I mean, I know there's this thing called ambition, but... You know, ambition without check is actually a dangerous thing, so... I'll just mark this as exit right here. Or rather, exit down. Let's check what this area has to offer. An orc? That's what this area has to offer. And this is a dead end, so let's just mark this place as a dead end, just so that we don't go down here ever. Expansive dungeon, I must tell you. skeletons and orcs, but yes, right here. Why don't you guys come over here so that, you know, I can take you both on, or, you know, take you on one by one. Alright, I'll position myself so that it's easier for us to engage in combat, because otherwise I can't kill you. The dude snarls when he attacks. And plops down like he just got melted. 3 points of experience, so where do I want to put this? In luck? I mean, that would be good. But I really think we need some willpower here. What else do we want? Maybe a bit of luck. You never know. I see an orc. More like I see a dead orc. But oh well, you get the drill. I shall just mark this point as exit right. Just so that I don't get lost here, you know? How it is. Over time, people tend to get lost inside dungeons. There are enemies nearby. Yeah, come along. Where are you, enemies? I would like to kill you. An actual human. I might just need to use a health potion with this dude. Because they do deal a lot of damage, and more than the damage which they deal, they actually... have a lot of health points and are more difficult to hit. So... yeah. That's nice. Chain pauldron left. Vorax. Oh, there was a spell sword. Well, at least I'm fully healed now, so. Well, I guess this would be it for this video. I shall meet up with you guys later. Until next time, take care. We will be stuck in this dungeon for, I think, around 4 to 5 videos, so, yeah. Farewell, fellow Oathlings, or maybe I'll just, you know, stick all of this into one video and post it like a large video, or, you know, only the video following the pathway to the objective, but then again, I still think it would be a large video, so I'll just post like 4 to 5 parts of it. I have a feeling this is going to be a long let's play, or a first let's play, so anyway, so take care guys, until next time, farewell fellow Oathlings.